Come on through, guys. This is the nerve center of the family music industry. Yeah, this is the piano here. Right. Now, quite an old piano. It was actually made the year my grandfather was born, believe it or not. My life has become, or has almost always been, a bit like a novel or an opera itself. It's worked in phases, almost like acts of a play. And the reason that I stopped working in opera was that everything had come suddenly to an end. So anyway, when I was a child, music didn't mean very much to me at all, except for the fact that when I was quite small, probably even before I went to school, there was a program on the radio, and this theme tune used to make me cry. Beautiful tune called Elizabethan Serenade by Ronald Binge. The first record I had was the overtures of the Gilbert and Sullivan operas, and almost immediately the music clicked. It just came into focus. But it didn't all happen at once. When I left school, I went to the BBC in White City in West London. I worked there as a sound technician in television sound. Something quite strange happened one evening while I was working quite late on a big orchestral take. A lady with a cello appeared, and that was actually Jacqueline Dupré. She was an absolutely amazing person. She just exploded music. I had a little chat with her. I told her that I would like to be a singer, and she said, "Well, you are very, very musical, although you may not know it yet. Trust the music, darling, and follow your nose." And she kissed me on the nose and went, you see? And then I began to follow my nose. I'm still following my nose, actually. I auditioned then for Welsh National Opera. That was quite handy because they put me on their books. So there I was, I walked down to the rehearsals and I went into the Prince's Theatre in Cardiff. We had special passes issued, so I walked in and I said, "Oh, good morning, I've come to work with Welsh National Opera. Do you want to see my pass?" "No," he said, "it's all right, mate, you go on in, you look operatic." See, so I went on in, and that was my first sort of entry to the Prince's Theatre. Initially, I liked it quite a lot, and I was in several productions for them. I was what they call extra chorus. It was the best of times, it was the worst of times. The most painful thing about that was you're away from your family, and I'd gone through by then a very nasty divorce. The whole thing was extremely unpleasant, and that was causing me a great deal of stress and anxiety. And the effect of that was that I was beginning to lose my timing and my memory. When you've got sort of problems with your technique, it begins to go, then you get frightened. Let's go. Oi, not too fast. I've got to get up.
One partner in paradise. This is not paradise.
I haven't deliberately sung in public for about 20 years, but I do let rip sometimes, and I sing out when I'm out with the dog.
Normally when I'm out in the garden, or sometimes when I'm doing the birds or putting the bins out, we suddenly get this wonderful tenor voice come booming across from your dad's, from your kitchen. Yeah, it's lovely. It really is lovely to hear.
When I'm told that somebody has commented on it, I start to think, oh dear, oh dear.
My Lord, unholy memories of the time they slew, my Lord, when will this fire and on crime. Find its reward, its due reward, its reward. Oh, when will time avenge my lord?
Yeah. This is how I remember Cress in the opera. And also when I married him as well. That is Cress. And one day he said to me, oh, I've got some tickets, would you like to go to the opera? And I thought, I don't think so. So I told him at the time, Liz, who I worked with, she was an amateur dramatics. I said, I'll give the ticket to Liz because opera wasn't my thing, you know. And he was quite disappointed, I think, because I didn't go. And then one day he came up to me and he said, would you like to go to the opera and see me in the opera? And I thought, oh, okay then. And I didn't like to say no for the second time. So I did. And it was a bit of an experience because, you know, didn't really think much of opera. As time went on, I did find I got to enjoy watching Dad. And obviously, because he was in the chorus, you know, I was there, sat there, looking out for him each time and everything. And it was quite exciting. It's something that you can't forget. And listening to him then, it brings it all back. So it's like really lovely, really. And it's nice for you because you've never experienced him sort of doing singing. I'm going to start crying in a minute. Oh, sorry. No, it's really lovely.
Regular Voltaire thinks he's quite a lover,
but there's not much there.
What a cruel trick of nature. Living me with such a lass. God knows how I've lost it, living with this bastard in the ass.
Oh, master.
Go, master in the ass.
This one.
One of the strange things that, one of the questions you haven't asked me yet, but which I anticipate you will, is how does opera affect my everyday life? And the answer is, as a matter of fact, if you are interested to know, is actually that my boca is absolutely full of music all the time. And sometimes it just has to burst out. Vetro, mentally, or suspiro, felicem servo mio. Like that. And ben can van disio, e possedero vora. Vetro, permanda more, unitum vil oggetto, che me desto un affetto, che per me poi non ha. Che per me poi non ha. If you wanted me to describe my career in opera in three words, it would be strange but true. Strange but true. Now, I'm pretty good with the Mozart, but I'm not much cop with the bloody trolleys.
What do you think about having a wacky dad?
It's very interesting, entertaining, and... yeah, sometimes embarrassing, but I love it. Like, the fact that it's something that when I say to people, they are just totally amazed by. And I love coming home and hearing you, to be honest, and doing all this and finding out stuff that I've never seen is just...
yeah.
I love it, yeah.
Well, I'm very pleased to hear that. And you know that I'm not completely all hot air. Yeah. Yeah, well, it's been quite a lot of fun, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know.
But you do know when to in public say something.
Oh yeah.
Like, oh no, yeah. Dad, stop! No
yeah.
more.
Yeah, well that's
but
right.
It's nice. Yeah. I laugh yeah. about it.
Right, I'll be seeing you guys. All the best. Bye for now. TTFN. Ta-ta for now. Bye bye.
I do.
Making you mine. in your mind now.